Good afternoon, everybody. This is me again, Life Coach Sophie, and I am currently in my favorite square, Piazza Santo Spirito. And it's a little windy, and I'm getting a little bit wet because of the fountain, but I just wanted to show you that this is what is the real Florence for me. I mean, yesterday I was showing you the Ponte Vecchio and the backdrop, and that's gorgeous, but it's just, you know, the other side of the river for me is always pretty touristy, and I love hanging out in this square, and actually it's also very close to where I live. So welcome to my home, and maybe one day this will be your home as well, because today I'm sharing tip 2 of the 5 tips to how to move to Italy. It's a very simple and straightforward thing, but if you don't have a plan, you're not going to make this dream of yours work. So let's be very clear about this. You need a plan in order to make this happen, and it starts with, like I said yesterday, being very clear, having clarity, giving yourself permission to have this dream. But then, what does it really look like? What is it concretely? What are you going to do once you're here? And I would like to share my example with you, because that maybe has some tips and tricks in there for you as well. You can get inspired. For me, my Florentine life started here 8 years ago, and it was actually in Via di Santo Spirito, just right behind me, at a school. And I did a language course there the year before. And when I had decided to actually go, and initially I wanted to only stay in Florence for 5 months, I asked the school if they actually needed an English teacher there for their Italian teachers, because I really noticed that, you know, their teachers weren't that good at English. I mean, and sometimes it was useful to sometimes explain something in English. And I was like, you know, let's just try. You never really know. So I reached out to them and said, hey, do you need an English teacher for your Italian teachers? I could maybe be of help or whatever, do something. And they said, no, we don't really need that. But we do have this option for an internship. And we give this spot to usually a girl, or well, sometimes even a boy, to work as a secretary and to be like the secretary's assistant. And in exchange for that, I could, you know, take the lessons for free. And I was like, wow, that's amazing. It's because I reached out, I tried something, and they came back with this super cool offer, which would mean that I didn't have to pay for the classes for like 4 months, and I would also work. So I'd have structures to my day, I would meet people, I would really, you know, I had a reason to get out of bed. So I was like, wow, amazing how that all turned out. And so that's actually what I did when I came here. Like, I started out doing a language course, and then together with the language course, after a month or something, I'd like 4 hours in the morning I studied, and 4 hours in the afternoon I actually worked. So imagine picking up the phone for the first time in Italian. That is so freaking scary, but I did it because, you know, I had to do it. It was part of the job description. And that's how you really learn. And besides that, you know, we organized loads of cultural getaways, and we went for aperitivi and restaurant. You know, we tried out many different restaurants with the school, and so that's how I got into the Florentine life very quickly. And learning the language, I will talk about that more tomorrow, really helped me to connect with the local people, the local life, and to get what was going on. Because if you don't really get what's going on around you, and you can't really interact, then it's very easy to feel lost. But today we're talking about having a plan. So what is it? What does your ideal life look like here? Does it mean that you're studying the language? Does it mean that you have a job? Does it mean that you maybe make art? Does it mean that you make many new girlfriends? I mean, my group, the Yes Woman, is perfect for that. We're having the next meetup coming Friday at my favorite wine bar, Enoteca Sei Divino, and we're getting together again on Friday, and it's going to be awesome. Every month I do these meetups, and real friendships come out of it, because we have meaningful conversations, and it's really a beautiful place to meet each other and to make new girlfriends. So also, for example, joining the group, joining the Yes Woman, allows you to get in touch with other women before coming here, you know, so you set yourself up for success by already connecting, by already, you know, having some people you know here. And it's the same with my clients who I help taking the leap to Florence. Already knowing me and knowing that they can book a session with me once they've landed here gives them so much more ground, you know, to fall back on, in a sense. So that is also part of your plan. Have someone to hold your hand through the process, and you don't have to do it all by yourself. So that is also part of preparing for this leap and turning it into a success. Because, you know, if you can't just be like, hey, you know, I like Florence, let's go there and see what I'm going to do. I'm going to figure it out. I'm going to wing it once I'm here. That is just really trying to make it go wrong. It's like self-sabotaging the whole plan, because of course at some point you're going to be like, hey, what am I going to do today? I remember like being here after 5 months and I wasn't working at the school anymore, and I had to start up my teaching activities, and it was so hard because there was nothing I had. I mean, I was dating this guy and he had a dog, so I would walk the dog every day. And that was my really, you know, it's sort of you need some structure. It's just like back home, you need a job, you need a class to go to, you need friends, maybe you need a relationship that isn't maybe perfect yet. But it was okay at that time. I felt at home and okay, you know, at some point you get that isn't the right person. But I mean, I got to walk the dog and, you know, so I made myself have a successful experience by reaching out and trying to do things that lit me up. The same thing is, for example, very windy. I think it's going to be a bit rainy later on today. The weather has been so strange this season, but luckily it's not too hot, so that's good. I'm flying! Anyway, so another thing you can do that's part of the plan is coming here beforehand and coming to one of the meetups and already sharing, you know, what your challenges are, your questions are, or putting them in the group even if you can't make it to Florence, and preparing yourself by getting to know as much as you can before coming here. So really dare to ask. And a simple thing, like already checking out some yoga schools or checking out like a painting class or already following some classes at your language school before actually moving here, is of so much value, because you can already feel into what it's like when you're actually here. The same with becoming a member of other groups, Foreigners in Florence, A Friend in Florence, read all about Florence on the blog A Girl in Florence, Giorgia Giupi, good friend of mine, she's amazing, and she gives you all the information you need, you know, to know about Florence, great tips. And so do the pre-work. And if you're from the States or from outside of Europe, you know, you need to get your visa in order. So there are so many things that you need to do for that, to prepare. I can help you to get a student visa with that school I talked about before. But if there's another kind of visa you want, you need to really dive into that and see what options there are. There's a lot of pre-work that can be done, and in that way you set yourself up for success. So really try not to see it just like, oh my God, this is an amazing adventure. You know, I did that. I did that when I went to Berlin in August 2 years ago, and it was fine. I had to do that because I had to get away from it all to get that this was actually my home. But I went there and I had no plan whatsoever. And so I came there, I had an Airbnb for 1 week, and then I changed to this other really lovely apartment. But I didn't have a plan, and that also caused some sort of, I mean, it caused a lot of freedom, but also a lot of like, oh my God, I feel really, really uprooted. I didn't know what to do. For me, it was exactly what I needed. But if you're serious about moving here, do prepare yourself. Apparently, I wasn't serious about moving to Berlin, because I would have prepared myself way better if I really wanted to move there, you know? So that's also how you can see how much you actually want something. There are two kinds of people. There are people that always look for excuses, and there are people that always look for solutions. And I'd like to invite you to be the person that always looks for solutions. If you want something, then go for it, but you need to make a plan so that you can actually turn it into reality. You know, I really love working with people that both have their head in the clouds and dream, but also have their feet on the ground so that they can actually turn, you know, what they dream about into reality. And if you need any help with that at all, any practical mental support, I'm here right for you in Florence. And we can do our sessions on Skype. That's what I do with loads of clients of mine, even from Australia or the States or from England. And then they move here, and it's so cool to then continue our sessions in my garden or having a coffee at my favorite coffee place and just really follow their process. So if you feel like this is my dream and I want to do it, I want to move to Italy, but I just need some guidance, then please please reach out because you make your life so much easier and you really increase the odds of you having an experience that is working for you instead of feeling like a failure when you need to go back after half a year because you've run out of money, you don't have any friends, and you know, maybe you run into some Italian guy that maybe doesn't treat you too well, and then your whole experience turns into this big failure. I don't want that to happen to you, and I'm not saying that has to happen, but it's like when you prepare yourself well and you have someone to look at the plan with, you know, a pair of extra eyes, that always helps. So give yourself that that help, that guidance, and I would love to be that person for you. So make a plan, write it down. What does your vision look like? What do you want to do? Write it down and make simple baby steps. Like if you want to study at a language school, well then go and check out some language schools, you know, contact them, compare prices, see what's right. If you want to attend yoga classes, go and look up yoga classes, yoga schools, and you know, reach out. It's what happened to me as well. Like I just reached out, I tried, you know, I even set up, once I was here, I set up a group English teachers in Florence because I wanted to create a community. I just do stuff and then stuff happens. So I would like to invite you to do the same and be proactive about it, because then the universe sees that you're serious about this and meets you halfway. So again, if you want to get some extra help, I'm your lady, and this is Life Coach Sophie, live from Piazza Santo Spirito, my favorite square in Florence. And let me show you a bit more. It's so windy, it's crazy. And these are my best friends. Hi! The bums in Santo Spirito. It's part of the Cincinnati people. Okay, I think this is my cue to call it a day. Have a fab day and talk to you tomorrow. Step 3, learn Italian. Ciao, ciao!